My husband woke me up with the words, there's been another shooting. So I don't know if you're aware, but we had El Paso, and sorry for tiny ears, well, I'll try to keep it broad. 20, El Paso, Walmart. 19, Dayton, Ohio. 29 lives. 29 candles. It feels wrong to light them because they've all been extinguished. Today we are going to be kind of treading that line of humor and tragedy, but that's what happens when you actually plan worship. But I think that metaphorically, to try to get to the grace in the midst of the carnage, I think that's powerful in and of itself. For all these lives, to get to the love of Jesus, to get to the redemption, to get to the, I think that's what we're faced with today. But like planning, Michelle Stafford has an amazing song for us today that just kind of is God-given. And let's just have a moment of silence and a moment of prayer before we jump in, because there's a lot to jump into today. And your sweet little girl. I'm so glad she's here. What's her name? Hey, JoJo, I'm Pastor Heather, and I won't come any closer. Yeah, most are, especially when faithful. We're so glad you're here, JoJo. Are you with Grandma and Grandpa? Oh, it doesn't get any better than that. One more coming? Oh, like in a seat in a chair. Okay. So much for quiet. Let us pray. Lord God, in the midst of worship, we are taking note of creation. And all that you have given to us to be caretakers of, the stewards over. And some things we have done better jobs than others. And today, we stand in the light of 29 lives that have been lost. And it seems that somehow there is work to be done. And without standing on one side or the other, Lord God, help us stand together on your side that asks us to be caregivers of this world and everything in it. Help us to be mindful of the lights, 29 that shine brightly before us, that within a period of 14 chronos hours were violently extinguished. And yet, let us hold their light in the midst of the grace of remembering you and how you gave yourself for us. Help us hold each of the 29 in your light and in your love. Even as you receive them, help us to hold their light and not extinguish it out of busyness or distraction. Help us be mindful of the way forward. Oh God, from our news to our hearts, oh God, to your ears, we offer this. And we ask, oh God, in your mercy, hear our prayers, and in your love for all of humanity, guide us. Amen. Okay. My name is Heather Seaman. I'm the pastor here at Community United Methodist Church. Yesterday, there were six of us who gathered, who took a very circuitous route to a cemetery up in Newport, Washington. And it was there that we committed Willard Loudon Clark's ashes to the earth. It was honestly very lovely, very meaningful. There was a single chrysanthemum. There was a picture of all who attended his memorial service. And there was the obituary that he wrote for himself, which is beautiful because it just highlighted everything that, you know, he thought was important. Family, education, faith, farming. Oh! And it brought to not a conclusion, but kind of a threshold to a new time of really remembering Willard and remembering that he is solidly in the arms of his Savior and hanging out with his mom and dad. Anyway, so that was a big deal. Also, this Wednesday, if you are interested, we have been doing our summer connections, which if you've looked at the different arrows, you'll see the many people that have done that. We will meet, I will be there at McEwen Park, so I will be paying the $5 to get in. The band may not be your favorite, but you know what? Something about being in the midst of community is a good thing. So I'm gonna go, and if you just kind of head to your left, I'm gonna head to my left. So if you wanna stay away from me, go right, go right. But I will be there, and I'll be looking for you. Tony will be there, Abigail will be there, so there'll be a flock of three, and so please come on, come on. We can enjoy some time together. Put that on your calendar. And also today, we are having the opportunity to hold up, Emily, what's the final number of IMP?
17.
Kids and adults, or?
Kids and adults.
So three adults, 14 kids will be coming out of this congregation in one way or another and heading up to Rathbone to attend Idaho Mission Project, which means we have 14 kids and three adults who will be let loose upon this community to do acts of justice and mercy. And so we will be thinking about them and holding them close as we pray them forward and as we worship. So that's a big deal. An Idaho Mission Project, IMP. And I let you know because this is one of those things that a seed was planted and we started off with a few kids. But then these few kids are like, wow, I can go hang out with my friends for a week. And yeah, I can work hard, but then we can swim and we can just kind of develop a sense of community. And then they invited their friends. And they invited their friends. And so we're up to 14, and this is on top of the, how many, six we had going to Houston. And there's something lovely about it, because even if this is just their one connection, it is a 24-hour, 7, 5, 6 days a week connection that they are in a Christian community, that they are serving beyond themselves, and they are understanding that people live differently than they do. And I am dimes to dollars, this will stay with them for the rest of their lives. So this is very exciting. So please hold us all, especially the adults, Emily Wise, Elise Staley, and myself, in your hearts. It's a big deal. And Rath and Twinlow itself, because there have been algae blooms in the lake. And it was a great question, and somebody said, but what is that, you know? Well, if you're 15 years old and you've sweated all morning, working really hard, you want to just jump in that lake. And so we're trying to figure those things out. I don't envy Emily as far as what's safe and what's not safe as we kind of go forward. For deciding, should they go into the lake or should we really look at what's on the internet and be scared to death? Anyway, Heather. Please find a number of white cards, your yellow cards, your communication cards, your connection cards, so that we can know that you're here. John Edgar says they're green, and it is great to have you here. And so please, we will have kind of a roller coaster, but just, again, hold those 29 and a whole tiny people like JoJo, whose world we are holding in our hearts and in our prayers and in our action, in our faith, in our politics, and in our priorities as a community. And I'm not telling you what your priorities are. I'm not telling you your politics. But I am telling you that they are all related. Let's rise and join together in our call to worship as Karen Brinkle comes forward. It is lovely to have you here. Actually, when the time comes, that's going to be the scripture.
Good morning.
Good morning.
dwell in God's shelter. Let us dwell in God's work of art. Come, because the earth is the Lord's and God's earth is our home.
We live in God's world. We are not alone. We share this life with the heavens and the earth, with the waters and the land, with trees and grasses, with fish, birds, and animals, with minerals and creatures of every form, and with all our brothers and sisters. God is good.
Spirit of Christ.
We are grateful for those heroes, for those angels. And we are grateful for those who are in our everyday lives, who also show us their angel's heart. But to O God, we pray for our world, 14 hours, 29 lives, and the count may very well rise. What kind of earth did you create for us? One of abundance and perfection. One of life and giving and generosity. And yet it seems, oh God, here we are again. We are a huge nation with lots of different people, with lots of different understandings, and yet I truly believe that life is a priority for all of us. Love is a priority for all of us. How, oh God, might we come together in ways that speak to those priorities? In ways that we might share those priorities. It's not an easy problem, and it's certainly not an easy answer. But Holy God, with you in the midst, we trust that it's possible, for you created all of us in our complexity. Even as we look at the candles and their holders on the altar, it's difficult to decide which one is more beautiful. Because in simplicity, there is elegance. And in complexity and color, there is bounty and vibrance, which is to be valued more than the other? Or are they valued because they all bring light and life in their uniqueness? Holy God, as we go today, forgive us for us overlooking the gifts of complexity and diversity and creativity and life, because we are busy people. And we're so busy that maybe we'll forget about this again. And we'll forget next time there is to do something or vote or make a motion. Oh God, as we at the corner of Ramsey and Hanley seek to understand what it means to be disciples, help us to understand that caring for one another in all of our safety and health and goodness and life is a part of our discipleship. And help us to draw lines, and help us to care deeply, and help us to invest personally, spiritually, and all other ways, and not just move on, thinking that there's nothing we can do. We pray for this world because the fact of the matter is this isn't just our problem. Others deal with violence and hatred and mental illness. Let's scoop them all up and pray for them as sisters and brothers. Help us to go forward without fear and trying to be in relationship so that fear may go away and instead a sense of understanding. Words, words, words. Thank you for the songs that touch our hearts. God of grace and God of glory, for the facing of this hour. Be with us and draw us together in unspeakable, sacred ways as we say the prayer your Son taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. And I ask you to please come forward as we prepare to give gifts and graces of our hearts, that they might be shared with others, hopefully people we've never met, but who will be touched by your love and grace. Thank you.
beautiful day that you have given us in Heartland, Idaho. We pray for those who today are surrounded by violence and what it has left in their lives. Lord, we just thank you for the bountiful gifts that you have given us, and we pray that you would use these gifts and ties that we offer back to you to touch the lives of those who are so in need. We ask this in all things in your precious name. Amen. Today's scripture is from the book of Matthew, chapter 6, verses 28 through 30. And why do you worry about clothes? See how the flowers in the field grow? They do not labor or spin. Yet I tell you that not even Solomon in all of his splendor was dressed like one of these. If that is how God clothes the grass of the field, which is here today and tomorrow is thrown into the fire, will he not much more clothe you, you of little faith? The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
I know that we had someone just visit Alaska Oh, the pictures they sent back and the glory that they felt from just being there and looking and experiencing. They might just suggest that Alaska is God's country. Scripture tells us that we as human beings, though, are sent, beings in the first of creation, were given dominion of all. So it's ours, people, it's ours. Genesis 1:27. So God created man in his own image. In the image, God created him. Male and female, he created them. And God blessed them and said unto them, be fruitful and multiply, replenish the earth and subdue it, and have dominion over the fish of the sea, and the fowl of the air, and every living thing that moveth upon the earth. Literally, the world was ours, wrapped up in a bow and given to us. Dominion means sovereignty or control, supremacy, dominancy, superiority. Wow. As we understood life and our place in the world as God has given it, it was ours, all about us, and God provided it for us to flourish, for us to do well, to be fruitful and multiply. And we understood that the time frame on that was until Jesus came back. And now it's going to be soon. 1 Thessalonians 5, now brothers and sisters, about time and date, we do not need to write to you, for you know very well that the day of the Lord will come like a thief in the night. Just like that, out of nowhere, unexpected, it will come. He will come and he will be here, and it will be the beginning of the end, and the end of the beginning, all of it. Matthew 24:36-37, but about that day, no hour, no one knows, not even the angels in heaven, nor the Son, but only the Father. As it was in the days of Noah, so it will be at the coming of the Son of Man. And time passed, and we as human beings, God's crowning glory. We have done dominion well in the context of how we have understood creation. But too, as time passes and we await the return of Christ, the dominion that we have lived into so incredibly well, we find is taking its toll. In terms of valuing creation, in terms of caring for creation, in terms of allowing for creation to provide as well as for us all to flourish. And not just us all, but future generations and different life forms across. And so as we stand on the threshold of an incredibly beautiful place, as we stand on the threshold of creation, how does faith inform how we live and make our way in the world as individuals, as groups, as nations, as groups of nations, and as a globe? Did you know that as United Methodists, as a historical mainline denomination connected globally, we have come together through prayer, scripture, and actually have made and published a statement as to how we believe we as United Methodists should act and be in this world regarding creation. You know, as we are in the Pacific Northwest and the Inland Northwest, and churches pop up all the time, and new is always better, and we see mainline denominations kind of faltering, we wonder, well, what's the big deal? But this is one of the gifts that we have as a global mainline historical denomination. We're not just coming up with things, we've been around. We have come together and we have thought and prayed and used scripture in our minds and yes, even our intellect and science. Think about these things. And we've created things called social principles. Perhaps you've heard, and if not, you will soon as we enroll our discipleship way for us to learn and grow. Social principles, another act, a positive act from things like General Conference. If we're left, some of us Methodists wondering, what good is General Conference? They made the beginning of a statement. All creation is the Lord's, and we are responsible for the ways in which we use and abuse it. Water, air, soil, minerals, energy resources, plants, animal life, and space are to be valued and conserved because they are God's creation. Not solely because they are useful to human beings, God has granted us stewardship of creation. And I'm going to give you the dot, 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 and jump down a little bit further. Therefore, let us recognize the responsibility of the church and its members to place a high priority on changes in economic, political, social, technological lifestyles to support a more ecologically equitable and sustainable world, leading to a higher life quality for all of God's creation. It can get a lot more specific than that. But when we talk about how our faith feeds and informs our living and our lifestyle and how we are in this world, I think the social principles are a pretty good place to look and to start. And so today, in seeking different ways to think about things and to ponder God's creation, our place in it, and God's place in it, Carol, I'd like to come forward. Such is life.
Jesus! Yes, Peter! Do we have to believe everything that's written in the Bible?
You mean there's something you don't understand? Intuition, Peter. Intuition, then mind reading.
Mind reading? Ha.
The passage you have difficulty with is... comes from Psalm 65.
How did you know?
Psalm 65, verse 13.
Jesus.
The valleys are so full of corn. They laugh and they sing.
How did you know?
Followed closely by Psalm 148, verse 7. Praise the Lord from the earth, you sea monsters and ocean depths.
But Jesus, how did you know?
Go on, tell us. You're a psychic.
No, Peter, I'm perceptive. Last week we both sang those exact songs in the synagogue. You were standing two down from me, remember? And at these lines that I just said, you blew a raspberry, something like, Peter, everybody heard you. There were only 6 people at the service.
Well, no wonder.
You can't say these things.
What things?
About valleys laughing, sea monsters praising God. It discredits the...
Peter, in your eyes, it might discredit the integrity of the Bible. But in God's eyes, it expresses the integrity of creation.
What do you mean?
What do I mean? Answer me this. What does thunder do?
I don't hear anything.
Then use your memory. What does thunder do?
Roar.
Grim. What does wind do?
Whistle.
What does the tide do?
In goes out.
Proper terms, Peter.
Ebb and flow.
Okay, what does the sun do on the waves?
Dance.
Absolutely. What do the birds do first thing in the morning?
Sing.
And what do the flowers do when fully grown?
Boop!
And who is it all for?
Pass.
No, no, Peter. There is no passing this test. Who is it all for? Who is the roaring and the whistling and the dancing and the singing? Your words, Peter. Who is it all for?
Us.
Well, what about before us? We're here, Peter. Who is it all for then? Need me to tell you that there was life on earth before humans walked on 2 feet? That there was worship, in fact, on earth before humans ever even sang a hymn?
How come?
You're just like the rest of them, Peter. You think that religion is only for human beings. You forget that God made the whole earth and all of its creation for God's glory. And that every creature in its own way is meant to worship God. That's why the birds sing. That's why the tide ebbs and flows, and the rocks resound, and the fields get dressed up in bright, beautiful colors, and the valleys laugh and sing.
Jesus, don't talk romantic.
I'm not talking romantic. I'm talking real. And you and your like-minded friends had better learn to respect the worship which Earth reflects. Because if, for any reason, one species of bird no longer sings, one lake of water no longer sparkles, one forest of trees no longer claps its hands, God would want to know why. Ecology is doxology, Peter. Doxology is praise and thanksgiving. To care for the earth means to preserve its praise.
That's heavy stuff, Jesus.
God is not a lightweight, Peter. I invite you to please stand as you're able. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead, he ascended into heaven, and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father.
It was shed for many people to forgive.
precarious as it is to put hands in and out between these candles, so life is precarious, so balance of creation is precarious. Pour out your courage and your safety and your love and your wisdom upon us. Pour out your forgiveness upon us, O God, that we may receive your grace in these gifts of bread and grape juice, that we might be reminded that we are bonded by creation, and too, we are bonded with your love for us and your life given to us. So bless us all as we come forward. Bless us all as we live in your grace. Help us to make the most of it and to share it with others. Amen. Amen. I invite Carol to come forward, Steve to come forward, and Michelle, would you help me out too, please? This table is open to all. Jesus had each and every one of us in mind when he invited us to remember and to live into his grace and fullness. And so if you are gluten intolerant, we have alternatives. And we take by intention to receive a piece and then dip it in. But then we also have tiny cups, if that is helpful to you. So as you, the ushers kind of indicate, please come forward. You are all welcome. So please, come forward. extinguished is significant. Let us not forget that. Let us go in the power and light of Jesus Christ. Let us go understanding that we hold our light in His light. And let us share that in this world. Through grace and mercy. Amen.